If you're one of my regular viewers, chances are you already know I do a lot of custom shot shell development. This week, I'm going to introduce you to the Pressure Trace II, one of the tools I use to analyze my ammunition and determine chamber pressure. This is extremely valuable to me in that it not only helps to establish whether or not a round is safe to use, but also how changing components, shot column height, or even the style of crimp can alter the pressure and performance of a shell. Let's begin by taking a look at the hardware. The unit itself is actually built right into a Pelican case. This is fantastic as these things are built like tanks and will provide a very reliable, waterproof and shockproof housing, which is important as this thing isn't cheap. Inside you'll find a strain gauge cable, as well as a small extension which we'll look at more in a bit. The construction of this tool is just incredible. The top plate is brushed metal, the LEDs are large and bright, and the controls are clear and well labeled. It's obvious that the folks at RSI take great pride in their work, and that's reflected in the craftsmanship. In addition to the device and cables, this system also comes with a strain gauge. Every time a firearm's discharged, the barrel momentarily expands in reaction to the pressure, then contracts back to its original dimensions. When properly mounted above the chamber, this tiny sensor will measure and record those changes, allowing the included software to calculate the pressures within. Connecting the system's a piece of cake. The first thing we'll do is attach the included extension cable. Although not mandatory, this does give us a little bit more slack when using the firearm to help avoid loosening or interfering with the gauge. Next, we'll connect the data cable in the same manner. With that done, we'll plug the other end of the data cable into the Pressure Trace II unit and secure it in place. In terms of hardware, we're now ready to go. As the Pressure Trace II's computer interface is wireless, connecting it to my laptop is as easy as turning on the Bluetooth adapter and starting the program. Here I've entered all the pertinent information, including the outside and inside diameters of the barrel and chamber, as well as the details of my verification load, basically a load with a known pressure value used for comparison. With the system connected and configured, measuring chamber pressure is a breeze. We simply click the shoot button and proceed to fire. With each shot, the system automatically records and graphs the chamber pressure, as well as other information like the ambient temperature and atmospheric pressure. If something goes wrong, for example, the system mistakenly interprets closing the action as a shot, you simply select and delete the erroneous reading and you're back in business. As a Pressure Trace II system also supports a chronograph, you can either connect a supported model directly or manually enter data from your own after the fact. One of the great things about this tool is you can do all your shooting during the day, then pack up and analyze the actual data from the comfort of your own home. Every test profile is saved and ready for you to review and compare. I can't begin to tell you how many questions this system has answered for me. Everything from how fold crimps compare to roll crimps in 12-gauge pumpkin balls, to whether or not mica wad slick actually reduces barrel pressure. I can't say enough good things about the Pressure Trace II. If you're interested in learning more about it, or purchasing one for yourself, I'll post the manufacturer's information in the details below.